Okay, so hello everyone and welcome back to another Game Dev Vlog video. This week I don't have too much to show you because I've mainly been working on the gas rendering system. And yeah, that's been taking me quite a lot of time, but yeah. So as you might remember from my last Dev Vlogs, the way I used to render the gas was to just basically render a small gas cloud on top of every tile. And with the transparency of the cloud corresponding to the amount of gas in the tile. So like in these open air blocks, there would be a lot of gas, so it would be very opaque and not very transparent. While in like dot blocks, for example, there was just a little bit of gas, so it would just be a very transparent gas overlay basically. So yeah, in that matter, it worked kind of fine. But there was also a problem with that, because while the rough distribution of the gas was kind of right, when it came down to the pixel level, like at the boundaries of the blocks, gas would just blend with everything kind of equally, so there were no clear defined borders. So for example, the gas clouds of these empty tiles right here would just overlap with the blocks nearby, and since I couldn't control like parts and transparency of parts of the gas cloud and only transparency of the full gas cloud, which covers both the block and the empty tile, it wouldn't really work to have a boundary basically. So the border of the block would always be also covered in gas, and even worse, when there were items on the ground, they would also be just basically hidden behind the gas, just as the gray background is also hidden there. So dirt, for example, would be barely visible, and yeah, so as you can see, now it is visible. I changed that, and the way I'm doing that now is that basically, instead of adjusting the transparency of these gas clouds, I'm actually doing that on a per pixel basis. So to do that, I'm first rendering these gas clouds to a frame buffer, basically, where they can. So I render them based on their pressure. So in the frame buffer, they are all about the same transparency, because the pressure is like about the same everywhere, so that it's just kind of a uniform gas layer to work with. And then when I render all the blocks and items to my mainframe buffer, I actually also use a second texture to store information about how much gas should be in front of the item I'm drawing. And so then in next step, I can basically combine all of that by using the second texture to render the gas layer to the mainframe buffer with the correct transparencies. So all of that is kind of a little theoretical, but the cool thing about that is that I can actually show you this right now, because, wrong button, I actually added a debug option to print and also save different textures and frame buffers as an image. So if I click this button right here, I can basically directly see the contents of the different frame buffers. So for example, here this is the image when this is the main frame buffer, when I have already drawn the blocks and the items, but not the gas yet. So that's how that looks. And then this over here is the second texture in this main frame buffer, where I'm storing the gas visibility values basically. So for example, this bright red here is this air pocket, and it just is basically a 1 in red channel, so that means that gas will be rendered at full opacity here. And then as you can see, the items here are slightly darker, or here for example, so that's about 0.5, so that means that the gas there will be rendered at half opacity. And then like these darker colors mean that the gas is just barely visible there. So for example, this is also on a per material basis for the different block types. So the stone over here is basically black, there is no gas inside of it, while the dirt is a little bit red, so it gets kind of overlaid with the gas. And yeah, the next step, I just draw the gas using this transparency information to another frame buffer, so that's how that looks. And then in the last step, I just combine all of that to create the final image. So yeah, overall I'm quite happy with how that looks, without it turned out, basically, because now, well, the items are definitely better visible than before. Even on higher gas pressures, you can still see them, even if not very good, but yeah, and also the blocks look a lot better, especially sand, with this curve that just used to look kind of weird because the gas would overlap with this curve a lot more than it would with the other corners of the blocks, but now that looks a lot better. And also, like stone inside of dirt used to look kind of weird because the two materials have different, like, I guess visibility values or whatever, but now this also looks kind of more smooth, so yeah, because it's on a per pixel basis, you know. So yeah, all in all, this was definitely a good improvement. Also, as I said, I've essentially written a simple method to save these images and textures and frame buffers or whatever as files, so I can definitely use that to do more with screenshots and so on later on. But yeah, that's about it for this video. I'll try to post another one next week, so I hope to see you there again. But until then, yeah, thanks for watching, I guess, and bye.